Hey guys, it's Axo here, and welcome back to a brand new episode of Until Dawn. Now, where we left off, I tried to investigate a sound that the characters thought was Jessica, and I kind of teased people with like pretending to open the door because I knew what happens when you open the door. Your character dies when you open the door, the trap door, and I kind of teased the people that were watching me because. I was really close to opening it, but never did. And, funnily enough, I got, people didn't like that. I noticed that I got more dislikes and lost a sub or two because of that. Mainly because probably people thought that I either A, they didn't like me teasing them, or B, they thought I killed off a character. Which, every character is alive so far. Don't worry about that. Every single character is alive. I've made sure of that. I've played this game so many times, I know how to save the characters. If I fail a quick time event or move on a don't move and that kills off a character, that's my fault. But if I will never die from a decision because I know the best decisions to make in this game. But other than that, Mike went out and blew up a place. He's crazy. He killed a couple Wendigos, and just blew so much up. Mike is amazing. Like, he's so skilled, he's really smart, but he's also incredibly, incredibly reckless. Like, he got hit with the blast. That's how close he was to the explosion. He got hit with the blast twice. But Mike fought a bunch of Wendigos, and he almost killed Emily. But he didn't. He didn't shoot Emily. So, let's continue. Sam in the mines. This is where we left off. I think I'm really close towards the end of the game. The character stats, the percentages, aren't showing up again. But, you know what? We move on. Funnily enough, my internet has been completely fine, but every single time I open Until Dawn, it just says that the network features are unavailable. Which I don't know why it makes it unavailable. Like, it just causes that error every single time I play this game. So, instead of fixing it, I might as well just continue with the game, because losing the stats aren't that detrimental. Sam, you just climbed an entire rock wall. You are impressive. And you look good doing it. I do gotta say. Jesus. Yep, that was Mike. Because he's crazy. He's a crazy fool. I don't know if that was Mike's first explosion or his second explosion. A totem? A totem. Okay, well, that doesn't seem like a good time. Obviously not, because it's a death, but she needs to watch out, I guess. Oh, this is the symbol we saw at the beginning of the game. With Mike, I believe. It was next to that stogie. First stuggy, the one that was already used. Nice. Nice, Sam. Samantha. Huh. Huh. It's a pipe. Look at that. Who would have thought? It's with a smile, Sam. Holy crap. Bang! You're dead. You're dead. Show your face. Yeah. Pop goes the weasel. He was straight up on fire going after Mike. Mike, I'm surprised your clothes didn't burn.
Define all right.
Alive, for a start.
Yeah, life's good.
Yeah. The hell are you doing here anyway?
I was gonna warn you about the Wendigos.
I think I got it.
Yeah.
Let's find a way down to where this fucker lives.
Okay, I'll skip this. You know what? I'll let it play. Why not? We're in the finale.
Mike, there's no key for the cable car.
Josh, he's gotta have it. He's gone. We're too late.
Shh, quiet.
It may have taken him down to the mine.
Wait, don't move.
Holy shit, what the fuck? I'm gonna get that key, right from that thing's goddamn bedroom, and then I'm gonna get us all the hell out of here.
Okay, that's not at all what happened.
Whoa.
I smacked that head
Let's
off.
Find a way down to where this fucker lives.
He didn't just, like, deteriorate. Repentance. 1 hour until dawn. What do you mean, 1 hour until dawn? I've been playing Until Dawn this whole time. Until Dawn's been happening. Dr. Hill, you don't look so good, by the way.
I wonder how much these sessions are of any help for you now. Just want to listen to me and things seems pretty... fucked up.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna leave you now, Josh. It's time you learn. There's more to be afraid of that can be dreamt up by the unhinged imagination of a self-indulgent, spoiled little brat. You had so many people who cared about you, who were willing to help. But at every turn, you choose to push them away. Now you're all alone. But by the sounds of things, it won't be long for long. No, you won't be alone for long.
His thumb went through his pants. I saw that.
Deep breath.
I notice stuff like that. Even if it's not like important at all, I notice stuff like that. Dr. Hill, love him or hate him, he's speaking straight facts. Deep breaths.
Get away.
It's probably
get away from me.
The only advice
no, you're dead.
That Josh can take right now. He's going crazy.
I trust you.
Josh, you're weird. Dr. Hill said deep breaths. You're not doing any deep breaths right now. Hold on. Zoom into his face right now. Zoom into his face, game. Are you doing deep breaths? No. It sounds like regular scared breaths to me. Not super deep, Josh. You don't even listen to your therapist even when you know your therapist isn't even real. Unbelievable. Crazy.
No. No. You're not real.
You're all alone down there. All alone.
Oh, wow.
But you're with us now. Family.
Get away from me! Get away!
Why didn't you save us, Josh? Why did you want us to die?
I didn't want you to die.
Jeez.
I swear.
Wow. Punch it! Give it a good old... Oh, how dare you punch a pig like that. Wow, now he killed a pig. Jeez.
Is this what you want?
No! No! Why are you doing this? Leave me alone! Why are you doing this?
Why did you save us, Josh? Why did you want us to die?
Dang. Josh is going through a lot mentally. Jeez.
I was not prepared for how ugly that thing would be up close.
Yeah. So, I noticed something kind of weird about it.
What?
The Wendigo. Had a scar.
So?
I've seen it before.
What are you talking about?
I saw these old pictures of some guys with that scar, and he was transforming into a Wendigo.
You're kidding.
It's one of the miners who'd been trapped back in the 50s in the cave-in. Which means that thing is 80 years old. At least.
Spunky for an old-timer.
They cleaned the place out. Killed a lot of people.
They? You mean there are more of them?
Oh, yeah.
How many?
Too many.
I think we're close. To the lair.
How can you tell?
I don't know. I just feel really terrible all of a sudden.
I mean, Mike, why are you talking about a Pokemon? First of all. Second of all, I don't think there's anything back here. I'm just going here anyways, just to see. Just in case. Okay, there really isn't anything back here. Third of all, you'll probably feel terrible, Sam, because you know that there's a crap ton more of those Wendigos now. That's probably why you feel so terrible. I mean, you're right about the lair.
I don't want to go in there.
There's no other way through.
He's right.
Is that what I think it is?
Shit. Looks like a grave.
Beth's watch. Wait, what was that shadow? That shadow was weird.
Oh, God. My kid. This is Beth. This is her watch.
What? Let me see.
Look. There was a cross here.
So this is where she was buried.
But who dug her up?
Good question. What's with these characters and having blood all over their clothes and not feeling like, hey, maybe we should wash these? She even has blood on her hands, and she's not, like, trying to get it off in any way, shape, or form. She's like, nah, it builds character. Even some characters in this game get, like, scratches and stuff like that. They don't even treat it at all. They just, like, let it bleed out. Or at least this water will take some of the blood out.
Sure?
Oh, I'm not dead yet.
Name is last words.
Oh, it's freezing. I can't feel my fingers. Wait a minute, I thought you reached the deepest part.
Well, I didn't say that. It was okay. You mean like there weren't any sharks or anything in here?
Sharks? Great. Thank you.
Mike's the best with words. Okay, it didn't clean off the blood off of her legs.
Shit.
Maybe it's dry.
Looks like Hannah's writing.
Day one. My little sister is dead. The fall killed her. I watched the color drain from her face. My leg is broken. I'm all alone, stuck here, with Beth's body. Sun will come soon. Day 5. I've never been so hungry. Feels like my stomach is twisting around inside. I took Beth's sweater. Much warmer now. She's still looking out for me. What do you mean, you took Beth's sweater? At the beginning, Beth gave you a sweater. Beth gave you clothes. I don't know. That's... I could have sworn I remembered her giving her a jacket or something.
Sorry, Beth. I have no choice. It's the only way I can survive anymore. If someone finds this, I'm sorry. I had to. I had no choice.
What does it mean? Jesus.
Forgive me, Beth. I'm sorry. My hands feel unclean. My nails fell out, pushed out. I'm aching, but no more cold. No pain. I'm getting stronger. Further writing dissolves into scrawls. Hungry. Punger. Hunger. That looks like hunger, but it looks like there's a P there. And probably the last one is hunger. Also, I noticed that the pictures that she's writing off, it's like there's a Black One Minds thing there. It's probably like notes or something. What's the other one? This one is restricted mining report log. You can't see them read them, but... That is a thing.
Oh God, it makes sense. I think Hannah dug up Beth. It was Hannah.
No, that's Michael, it's ridiculous.
Michael, it has to be. It's the only thing that makes sense. Beth died in the fall.
So what? What does that mean?
So Hannah must have buried her.
God damn it. God damn it.
Hannah was down here.
I don't believe any of this.
She would have been starving. She would have been desperate.
Fuck!
We need to find Josh. Right now.
I feel so bad for Hannah. Because not only was she bullied to the point of her, like, having to run away, but also she had to eat Beth. Like, she had to resort to cannibalism to survive. I mean, she died anyways, but... She was desperate. She had to do something. And Beth. Beth was already dead.
Oh, it's getting deeper.
Yeah.
Okay. Hey, it's slipping up again. We're gonna make it.
God, don't jinx it.
Come on. We made it.
Yep, we made it. Is the blood off her legs yet? Oh, I think so, actually. Oh no, I still see blood. Okay. Well, I'm glad they didn't put into the account of blood actually getting off people with water. But maybe it's like super dry. Maybe it just won't come off.
Oh,
Hi there. I mean a lot of them. I only see one.
Oh my god.
No!
I'm gonna be sick. Wait, hold on.
This part's really weird. Because they react as if they saw, like, something traumatic. I mean, they did see one body. But, like, that's the same reaction they would give if you kill off every character and all the characters belong. Show up there.
You can't God. Tell me what to do Buddy. Anymore. You can't tell me what to do. Okay.
So like, I don't know why they didn't just like give an extra dialogue just in case nobody died. It's kind of weird seeing them like react so horrifically to only one body.
What's the matter? He's tripping or something. Josh!
And gave him a good slap.
Josh! Hey, man! Don't hit me, please. Well, you were deep in it, man. Full metal jacket.
We didn't think we'd get you back. Josh, Hannah was down here for weeks, a month. She dug Beth up.
Sam.
Mike.
Hey, let's just get the fuck out of here.
Okay. Josh, do you have the key for the cable car?
Yeah.
See that over there? That means there's a direct way out. Come on.
Yeah. I mean, that's not really direct. That's more like...
If you help me up, I can go back to tell the others we're okay.
Yeah. Yeah, good.
You bring Josh back...
I don't know the word for it.
The lodge.
Be careful.
Yeah, you too.
Nice.
Alright, let's go, you fucked up son of a bitch.
I mean, technically, that light up there is also a direct way out. As she wants to...
You didn't have to hit me so much, man. I'm sorry about before, man. I thought you killed Jess. I was wrong.
Like, she looked at light, and she's like, oh yeah, that's direct. It's not really direct. It's only direct for her, because she can wall climb. And she needed help getting up there. Oh. Fortune totem. That doesn't seem like good fortune. That seems like bad fortune. Ha, got him. Great jokes. Great commentary. Josh, can you, like, walk a little faster? Don't tell me no. Yeah, I only see one body. I like that background noise. I never fully appreciated the background noise when I first played this game. You know?
I know.
What do you know? Josh, what do you know? You know something I don't, so what do you know? Do you know that I didn't fully appreciate the background noise when I first played this game? How would you know that? Creeper? Creepy creep, man. Creepy creep. Poor Josh, though. Should we... I'm just gonna turn around, because I saw that, and I don't wanna experience that. I think I'm good. Mike, why are you shining the flashlight in your own eye? I saw that. I can't go back. Okay, Mike, I saw that. Can you, He's shining the light in his eye again. Oh, never mind. Nope. He's like, light on, light off, light on, light off. Maybe if I don't move, they won't know I'm here. That's the deal with Wendigos. If you don't move, they won't know you're here, so... Okay. Oh, Mike, you're okay. You dodged that Wendigo like a boss. Maddie boy, I haven't seen you the entire game. Funnily enough, both Matt and Jess don't know anything about the Wendigos. Don't know that Emily got help. I mean, Matt does, but Jessica doesn't. Like, they both don't know anything. Ow! I pressed the wrong button.
Matt. No, Matt. Please.
Matt. Nice to see you, too.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Are you okay?
You kind of hit me pretty hard. Warn, there's a monster. Question, what happened to you? I mean, I gotta warn her. She knows. She does kind of know there's a monster, because the monster did that to her. So. I'm just gonna question.
How did you end up down here?
Mike and I were. We were messing around, and then it was.
What?
I don't know. I was by the window, and there was all this glass, and it was in the snow, and then it was moving so fast. Fuck. And then I was, just down here. Oh, God. Yeah.
Give her a hug or something. Give her some sort of comfort. I mean, are you upset at her that she straight up whacked you? She gave you a good whack. Not gonna lie.
Look at that. Some sort of cave in here.
It was me.
What?
I fell through that roof.
You fell this far? Jesus. That makes two of us.
When?
I fell off a goddamn fire tower down here.
You're kidding me.
Hey, they could both bond over the fact that they fell really, really far. And they both survived a giant fall. Gotta give props to these two. They went through quite a bit. I mean, Jessica went through a lot more. But they both went through quite a bit, and they're still standing. Ooh, totem. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. There's a lot of straight up scratches on Mike right now, or Matt right now. I don't know if that was the Wendigo or the fall, or that was Jess. Jess laid it on him thick. Really gave him a good one too with that. I pressed the wrong button. I have to, like, get into the zone. The auto zone. Pay attention to these button presses and not mess up again. Because honestly, I'm glad that these button mess ups that I've been having throughout the series is very minuscule.
Which way?
Hide. Jessica's not in the condition to run. Jessica's not in that condition at all. That was literally the worst time for my body to get a shiver. My body literally had a random shiver. And it's not from the game. And it's not from the cold. I don't know what it's from. But that was the worst time to have that, because I almost moved.
We gotta do this. Get out of here. Come on.
You got this, Maddie boy.
Jess, come on. Come on, come on. Jess!
She's not in a condition to run. What did I just say? Oh, shoot. Head together. Why would I abandon Jessica? She's like, okay, I don't know what you're doing. Oh. It worked. It worked, Jessica. Next time, don't question Matt's technique. Matt has an M on his clothing. That's how you know he's the real deal. Jump. Why not? There's really no point to going fast on these. But, might as well do it.
Come on.
Nice. Nice, Sam. I wonder if Sam did rock climbing before all this. Maybe she wanted to, but never got into it. Honestly, she should get into it again, because she's really good at it. I mean, Emily rock climbed earlier in the game, but Sam does it multiple times. Wait a minute. There's a totem around here. I remember distinctly when I last played this game that there's a totem around here. Where is it? Oh, it's right here. Okay, got it. I almost missed it for a second there. This is a big totem, so it must be good. Okay, well, that doesn't look good, but it might be. Danger. Danger. See, Sam's going fast. She's doing that brisk walk. Not only can she rock climb, but she can pull off a brisk walk flawlessly. That's just the Sam way. Honestly, Sam, I know it's really cold, but you should really wash your hands. Get that blood off. I don't even know whose blood that is. What is it? The Wendigo's blood? Might be. Maybe she got a cut on her hand or something. Look, whoever's screaming in the background of this game, you gotta chill. Alright, well, you tried. You tried, Sam. That's all that matters. Got it.
Oh,
What is that doing there?
Hey! Hey! Oh, come on, open up! Guys, come on, are you in there? Let me in!
Sam.
Mike. Oh, gosh. You look terrible.
Gonna look worse if we stay out here.
You know, that's really rude, Sam. I think he looks amazing. To be honest, he looks the exact same since the last time she saw him. So I don't know what she's talking about. Maybe she finally saw him in the light. And she realized, oh yeah, you're actually not the bee's knees.
Not good.
That's the first ever time you see them try to use electricity.
We should check the basement.
That isn't them starting it up using a generator. Remember this place, Sam?
How do you rate our chances of survival?
Hmm? I'm trying not to think about it.
I rate it a 6 out of 10.
Oh, shit!
Nice. What are y'all standing there for? Don't stand there. Do something.
Don't move. Don't fucking move a muscle.
She's already moving. Breaking the rules. Oh snap. The Wendigo sees another Wendigo. Let's see how they say hello. Oh, okay, well that's a weird way. Probably foreign. Ashley, why are you just standing there? Ashley's literally just like chilling. Well, when we're here freaking out, Ashley's not moving. Dang. That's skilled. Chris is going. Glad Chris actually did something. Save Mike, of course. Mike is the best. There's Emily. Why is Ashley the last person to actually do something? She was standing back in the background just chilling. There she goes. There you go. Nice job, Ashley. My hand was moving down during those. I don't know why. But I was looking at the don't move thing and my hand was slowly going down. Like every single time I was like, oh no. I was so scared I might have actually got almost... I was so scared I almost got Sam killed. Like it was like so close. I don't know why my hand was moving down. Whoa, 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 whoa.
Hold on. I'm seeing something. It looks like there are survivors. Let's pick them up.
Hold on, I'm seeing something. Oh yeah, it's a giant burning building. Oh my gosh.
No.
Oh.
If he attacked you.
He saved my life. And I watched him die.
I heard Jessica. I don't know how or why she was down there, but I know I heard her.
Chris heard her too.
He held it right up to my face. Right here, right in front of my nose, and he could have shot me. He almost shot me, the prick. I mean, you go out with a guy for however long and you think you know him, but man, this one really takes the cake.
I was right there and I could have done something. I tried to do something. It wasn't good enough.
You're good enough in my eyes.
How did you end up in the mines?
I was carried and taken and...
What did you see?
I don't know. I don't know.
He was out of his fucking mind. He wanted to hurt us. Okay? And I thought he was the one who attacked Jess.
I thought we were close. After his sisters disappeared, he'd come and talk to me. He said I was the only one who understood him. I thought we had a connection.
Poor Sam. She probably even had a crush on Josh.
After a traumatic experience.
I said I'm fine.
Okay, you're fine.
I stabbed him and I tried to get away, but I didn't know. I swear I didn't know.
Didn't know? Who did you stab?
Oh, I stabbed the maniac. I didn't know it was Josh, but then he was the psycho. And how was I supposed to know Josh had all the saws and the gun? And oh my god.
That doesn't really help your case.
Is he okay? Are they done looking at him? I'm just a little worried because, you know, I'm his girlfriend. Did he tell you that? I mean, I probably wasn't his favorite person there for a couple minutes, but he knows how devoted I am to him. He knows. He said he knows, right?
Probably.
Your friend Ashley, she told us she tried to help you. She said she heard you calling out.
Ashley's not the only one who heard it. Chris heard it too. I don't know why Chris didn't mention that.
What do you remember?
He came for me. He did.
Came for you?
Where is he?
I mean, well, he almost did. I got to stop.
You need to listen to me. I don't care if you believe me or not. It doesn't matter because you will. You need to go down to the mines.
What's in the mines, Sam?
I've seen what's down there. And I'd give anything to unsee it.
Dang. Monsters in mid. Oh. Oh, okay, more. But Chris has to mention that he heard Jessica too. He just wanted to give you a hug. He's finally getting saved. He just wanted a hug. Can't believe they rejected a hug. How rude. Okay, did I get all the clues? I got all the clues. Did I get all the totems? I did. I got every single secret in this game. So, if you ever want a 100% Until Dawn, just watch this Let's Play and you'd know where everything is. But let's watch the events of the past since I unlocked all the stuff.
Many years ago, my grandfather hunted those possessed by the curse. But there was one that eluded him. The fiercest of all, the Makapichu. It was a terrible thing.
Bless you.
And my grandfather could not defeat it. Sometime after, the prospectors came to mine this mountain until a cave-in trapped them in and woke the curse again. And there were dozens of men, no food, no light. And in that blackness, the hunger came. They were consumed by their abominable cravings and driven mad. Murderers. Cannibals. Eating human flesh. And if you kill this monstrous thing, the spirit is released and swirls the mountain like an evil wind waiting to possess again. You best not kill them, I have tried. You can only trap them, taunt them with fire. And after all these years, after many moons and many hunts, the Makapichu still roam free, out of my grasp, beyond my reach. Until one night, a year ago, I was finally able to get him in my sight. But we were not alone in the woods that night. While I was tracking the Makapichu,
I'm not going to. He was tracking something. I'm going to stop.
The Makapichu forced your friends over the mountain. There was nothing I could do. I couldn't save your friends, but I could avenge them. I hunted the Wendigo down and I doused it with fire.
They made it seem like he walked over there too late, but no, he reached out his hand for them.
Was dead.
Didn't he also say in his notes not to kill them? But okay. That was the end of... Oops. That was the end of Until Dawn. There's also bonus content for the behind the scenes and all that, but we're not going to watch that. That was Until Dawn. That was the best ending. That was all 100% all the secrets. Whatever you like to say on this finale. I knew that I was going to get the best ending, or I was going to try to anyways, because I knew how to do it. But at the very end, like, I don't know, something about my hands just kept wanting to go down. And I kept having to, like, push my hand up so that it wouldn't get it. But yeah, that's it. I'm so happy that I was able to play this game again, and I'm happy that you all enjoyed this series and enjoyed watching me play this game and try to make a couple jokes here and there. I apologize if the commentary isn't the best. It's kind of hard to think about things to say or what to do if I've already played this game so many times. And I can't really provide any new reactions, but I hope the jokes that I said were alright. And I apologize for the last episode. Y'all seem to not like that. I thought it was fun. But I hope you all enjoyed this series. I hope you all enjoyed me playing this game. And this game means a lot to me. It's like one of the first games I got on the PlayStation 4. And it's one of the main reasons why I wanted a PlayStation 4. Like, I didn't want a PlayStation 4 for any other game besides this game. Because I saw a YouTuber play it, I forget which YouTuber, I think I saw Markiplier play it, and I was like, ooh, yeah, I want that game. And I got it, and I platinumed it about the same month or even a month after I played this game. Like, I enjoyed it so much that I platinumed it, and in this Let's Play, I literally just platinumed it a second time. Well, not really, because there's a couple of trophies that involve you doing different decisions. But this game meant a lot to me, and it means even more to me now, knowing that the most popular video on my channel right now is an Until Dawn video with 300,000 views right now, which is amazing. This is like the most views I've ever gotten on a Let's Play. And it's the first series that I started this year. And I hope you all, you know, continue to follow me on this journey to keep watching future videos. I know a half of my subscribers recently, or just in general, are here because of Until Dawn and are here for Until Dawn content. And I will provide more Until Dawn content after this, so I hope you stick around. I hope you subscribe and stuff to look forward to the future Until Dawn videos. I have a couple Until Dawn related videos, like alternate scenes or alternate cutscenes or alternate dialogues that a lot of people have missed and or have probably never heard of or seen. It's like one of the biggest secrets in Until Dawn, and I think I mentioned this in a video, in an Until Dawn video earlier, that I don't think anyone's made a video on these dialogues. I've seen a couple dialogues here or there on the internet, but I've never full-on seen all of them, and I tried my best to get every single one, and I think I got all of them. I might play this game off-camera just to make sure I got all of them, but I'm pretty sure I do. So that video will be coming up sometime in the next month. And I will be playing Until Dawn Rush of Blood, the VR game, and I will be playing The Impatient. I will try my best to get those series out as fast as I can. I know Until Dawn Rush of Blood is only like 3 hours long, so I can get that game done pretty quickly, but The Impatient, I don't know how long that is. The Impatient, I've mentioned before, is the prequel to Until Dawn. It says what happens in Blackwood and what happened to all the patients and stuff like that, seeing people turn into Wendigos. I'm so excited to play that game because I've never played it, nor have I ever played The Rush of Blood. So I hope you stick around for those videos, those Let's Plays. And I hope you just enjoy future content. And yeah, I love this game so much. It's, even though it's like 5-6 years old, it's still one of my favorite games on the PlayStation 4. Still one of my favorites. I've been playing the Dark Pictures games, which is by the same people, and it doesn't have as big of an impact as Until Dawn was. Not only because Until Dawn has a bunch of extra content, and it's much longer, and it actually has huge stakes, and it has a bunch of celebrities, but also because it's like such a nostalgic game to play at this point. And funnily enough, I remember first playing this game. It wasn't like a first time reaction, because again, I watched a YouTuber play it, but just playing this game on my TV in like its full glory was just so fun. And getting all these secrets was even better. And looking at these butterfly effects, sided with Emily during the fight. What was the second thing then? I guess I never did the second thing. But just, this game is so fun, and I can't wait to see what these developers will come up with next. Despite the fact that the Dark Pictures games don't really have that big of an impact, I'm still a huge fan of these games, and they keep improving their games more and more and more and more. There's still a lot of problems with the future games. Like, they're very buggy at times, very glitchy. There's a lot of parts that just freeze up. They're not nearly as perfect as Until Dawn, especially considering they're making their games yearly. But I'm still looking forward to every single game that they make. I played almost every single game that they've made, except the mobile game. I know they made a game that was on a system that I've never heard of or never seen. I don't think it's mobile, I think it's something else, I forget what it is. But they made that game, and that's the only one that I haven't played. I've played Hidden Agenda, I'm going to play the Until Dawn and the Impatient, play the Dark Pictures games. Like, I'm a huge fan of Supermassive games, like a huge fan. So I just appreciate everybody that enjoyed this series, and you know, it means a lot to me that you all watch these videos, enjoy these videos, like the videos, and continue to watch these videos with me. Like, continue to play these games and stuff, and I, you know, it makes me really happy. I've been talking for a tangent for a while, but I just want to say I appreciate everybody that subscribed and joined because of Until Dawn. And I hope to continue to entertain you all. But yeah. This is all I'm going to say before I make the video too long. It's almost like an hour. But yeah, thank you everybody for watching. If today's your birthday, happy birthday. If you sneezed during this video, bless you. If you had a bad day, I truly, truly, honestly hope this helped cheer you up in some way. I hope it made you happy knowing that I got the best ending. And yeah, see you everybody.